God of Abraham, you're the God of covenants and faithful promises. Time and time again, you have proven you do just what you say. Though the storms may come and the winds may blow, I'll remain steadfast and let my heart learn. When you speak a word, it will come to pass. Great is your faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness to me. From the rising sun to the setting, same, I will praise your name. Great is your faithfulness to me.
I don't believe in fairy tales. I guess I've outgrown them. But that doesn't mean that I don't believe that there's something bigger than me. Cause I've seen it in a hospital room when the doctor said sorry. There's nothing more we can do.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Life. It is so good to see you all. I hope you guys had a nice week so far. In T-minus 5 days, we're gonna have Teen Week coming up. I'm so excited. Are you all excited? Yeah, let's go. So we're gonna have Teen Week very, very soon, and I'm excited that we're gonna have tons of games. We'll have snacks. We'll have a great time of worship. We'll have some really cool speakers coming to speak to you all, and that will be amazing. But I'm excited. We're going to show you in just a second your teams. If you have just signed up within the last, 2 days or so, your name is not on there. But know that if you just signed up, you will get your name on a team. So if we could show that slide, that'd be fantastic. Amazing. So if you don't see your name up there, please go talk to Jen or to Dan Salisbury in the back, and we can get you on a team. If you have not signed up online, please go and register, because you're going to get a free T-shirt for your color for your team. If you are not on a team or have never participated, please let us know, and we'll put you on a team or that type of thing. Was there another thing I was supposed to say? I can't remember. Anyway, we're so excited. We're going to spend a little time in prayer in just a minute, but I want to start off with prayer for our night together. Can we do that? Awesome. Yeah? Oh, I forgot about that. Well, I was trying to avoid that. Yeah. All right. Okay. Also, we've been Oh, that conveniently left my brain. Okay. Green team, I'm looking at you. What is our problem, guys? Let's go. It is true. We do nominate normally the week, but we got some problems, green team. Come on. We got to get it together. All right. Anyway, so we do have yellow team in first place, purple in second, green in third with zero. So I'm looking for green tonight to step it up and to really get some points on the board here. All right. All right. Let's start with a word of prayer. God, I thank you for today. I thank you, Lord, that we can come to Teen Life. Lord, what a blessing and an honor it is to come each and every week to not only glorify you, Lord, but just to get to know each other better, Lord, and to point each other to Christ. I just pray, God, that you would bless tonight, be with Pastor Greg as he speaks to us, Lord, that we would truly be listening to hear from you, and Lord, does it take one step closer to you each and every day. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Awesome sauce. Jared?
We are not going to play games. We're going to do something a little bit different. So I would like all of youth, to get with your team colors in the separate parts of the room. Please and thank you. I heard purple by the couches. Just kidding. I don't know what purple is. Yeah, I was just say.
Have you registered online, Joseph? Have you registered online yet? What team were you on last year?
All right. So what I'm going to have you do is take the next 8 minutes, and I'd like you to pray with your team captains, team leaders, and pray for this upcoming week of Teen Week. We know it's all about the games, excitement, snacks. That's all great, and it's awesome. But we also remember why we're there, that we're hoping for unsaved students and maybe unsaved parents will hear from their students. And also, for some of you that may need some things in your life you need to change. So the next 8 minutes, if you guys as a team can pray for Teen Week, that would be awesome. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much. May you gather in thy seats that you originally were in. Hey, I know you. Gotcha. So we are now going to hear the testimony from Jen.
Hey guys. So my name's Jen. Most of you probably know me as Logan's mom. Somebody actually said goodbye to me the other day as Logan's mom. It's kind of an honor. or Gavin's mom. He's been gone a couple years now, so I don't know if all of you know him. Savannah's mom, and then most of you probably know Maeve. and I'm Dan's wife. So I brought my phone up for some notes, only because once I start talking about Jesus, I can really start talking about Jesus. And all the Salisbury said amen. So in thinking about my testimony, I have a jam-packed life. I look much younger than I am. But I have a long and a lot of things in my life. So I tried to really think about what I wanted to focus in for you guys and what would probably be the most impactful for you. So I decided to kind of hone in on a couple different things that I thought as a teenager would have really helped me to hear from an adult. So I grew up in a Christian household. It was a different Christian household. I didn't grow up in a church like this. And I did not grow up in a youth group like this. I'm so happy that you guys have this youth group. I'm so glad it exists. I'm glad that my kids have gotten to grow up in it. I grew up in a church that did not teach the word. It taught it, just not correctly. So scripture was taken out of context. It was twisted. I grew up with a lot of false teaching and just a messy, messy background from scripture. But I went to church. We were active in music as a family. In fact, my family traveled as sort of a band, I guess you would have called it then. This was in the 80s, so it wasn't exactly hip or cool music. But we traveled from church to church and sort of did music. My home life was extremely chaotic. I had a very angry family. So it wasn't uncommon for the police to come to my house because there were outbursts of anger. So this sort of gelled with my thinking of God, because we would go to church and act one way, but my home life was very, very angry, right? So I began to have this sort of veneered Christianity, and what I mean by that is, like, we just put our best face on, right? And we act sort of one way when we go to church, but we're not exactly living that at home. And so that was sort of my thinking of God as I was very little, is just put on the mask and act a certain way, right? And God is pleased with that. But we don't necessarily have to behave or sacrifice our life to Christ when we're home. So it all got really messy. I had a really strong consciousness of God growing up, though. I loved the scripture. I didn't necessarily understand it very well, but I loved Jesus. I was always drawn to him. And as a little girl, I kind of thought about him constantly. Like, I always wondered what he thought of this or what he thought of that, or just all the time. I spent a lot of time alone, and I was always wondering the things about God. They just weren't well explained to me at the time. But I think God at that time was even drawing me at a very young age, and he protected me a lot. He was always near me. So from about the age, this is where my testimony gets a little funny. From about the age of 5 to about 21, I competed in pageants. So before I go too far into that, I want to give a caveat, because all my experiences were not bad. I had some great experiences in that world. I was able to have some time on television. I worked with some great producers and directors. And I worked with some amazing charities. So it was a good time, and God gave me great experiences in that world, and I met amazing people. However, if you know anything about pageants, you are judged all the time, right? So I kind of thought, as a teenager, when I was going through these pageants, right, and constantly being judged for the way I walked, talked, and the way I dressed, right? And if I met that standard that men had set for me, then I won, right? I succeeded. And so I got the accolades and the applause and the acceptance, which is really what every human wants, right? We want that acceptance, and we just really want to kind of find home, right? So again, along with my home life and these pageant experiences, I had this sort of veneered thinking of Christianity, right? If I could just look the part and think it and make everyone else think I was the part, then I'm accepted. So it's sort of like a washed pot, right? When Jesus says to the Pharisees, you're a washed pot, but it's just all dirty inside. That's kind of how I was, because I wasn't cleaning up the inside, right? I was just very concerned about pleasing everybody on the outside. And this became absolutely crushing, right? To try to always do the right thing so that God would accept me. It was a crushing, crushing life that I was leading. And there's this one scripture, Romans 5:8, right? While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And I remember reading that scripture and thinking, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. I'm still in the mud, and I'm still in the muck, and I'm very unclean, right? But Christ died for me. I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to look the part. I didn't have to wear the perfect dress or walk the perfect way. Christ just accepted me. And I remember, like, when that light broke through, it changed everything for me. There was a hunger inside me to know the scripture and to understand who this God was, that he would sacrifice himself for me, even though I had done nothing to deserve it. Absolutely nothing. So over time, God began to set me free. I don't have a specific date or time when I was saved. I remember when I was very little, I kind of said the prayer. But I don't think I really understood it then, because I was like 4 or 5. So I know I didn't understand what I was saying. So I don't have a time. What I know right now is I'm saved, right? I know that Christ is my Savior, and I know that I did nothing to gain that, that he did all of that for me. I can't look back and say, oh, there it is. I don't have a date in my Bible, but I know that God has absolutely set me free. And so now I have a passion for other people to know God through the scripture, and to understand who he is, and to understand that you are fully accepted because Christ did it all. There is nothing that you can add to that. There's nothing that you can do. You can never make yourself perfect. You can never be more accepted than you are in Christ. So I just, when I stand here, I want to kind of encourage you guys that in two things. One, you don't let the world define who God is for you. And you don't let your experiences define who God is. You let the scripture tell you, because God has revealed himself to us through the scripture. So we look for that. We look for him there and let him tell us who he is, right? There's this great story in Acts where Philip comes across this man and he's reading the scripture and he says, do you understand what you're reading? And the man says, no, I don't. How will I know unless someone explains it to me, right? And so Philip takes that time. So ask the questions. Seek God in that scripture, because you will find him. And then trust him at all times, that God is going to thread his will through your life as he's done with me. Look, I have ended up in a completely different space than I ever thought I would. But God has been so faithful through all of my experiences, and he redeemed them all, right? He has now used them to show a part of himself to me that I would have never known had I gone through that. And now it is deeply ingrained in me that Christ did it all for me, that I can't do anything to add to that. And I'm safe, and I'm secure, I belong, and I'm home, right? And that's what we're all kind of looking for. There's this beautiful psalm that Moses wrote, and the first two lines are, Lord, throughout all the generations, you have been our home. And I think deep inside, that's what we're all looking for. We look for home, the place that we can belong. And we find that acceptance through Christ. And that's where I found mine. So I pray for all you guys. I'm grateful that you have this youth group where you get these amazing teachings. So that's probably my story. Thanks for listening.
World, this life, we are. will not bow to sin or to shame. We are defiant in your name. You are the fire that cannot be tamed. You are the power in our veins, our Lord, our God, our conqueror.
Pray. God, I thank you for just bringing us all here together and just that we're able to be at Teen Life one more time before Teen Week, and I just pray that we're all able to just learn more about you and worship you. Amen.
If this works, not that you really need it, but for those online, they may need it. All right. So what we're going to do tonight is, I have to be honest with you, I'm getting ripped off. I don't get to participate in Teen Week. I'm on vacation. Oh, vacation, right? So I decided I wanted to have a little fun tonight. And so what I'm going to do, is this even on? Because I don't really know if I can, I feel like I'm holding it right up to, yeah. Can you turn it up just a little bit? Because I'm having to put it too close to my mouth, and that's kind of gross. All right, so is that, that's better? Yeah, okay. So I want you, if you're on, go ahead and get into your teams. I need you to get into your teams. Maybe you can spread out the way you were before. I don't need any really talking just yet. You'll be doing plenty of that. All right? But go ahead and get into your teams. If you're watching this online or watching this recorded, you know, I want you to be watching the teams tonight. So within your teams, all right, and so by the way, for an adult, I need an adult with this team. So you're with, you're even though on well, I think you qualify, Jared. Okay. All right. So so what I'm asking is that within your group, you need to decide who is the most outgoing individual, all right? Who is willing to kind of be goofy, loud, all right? People don't know this about me. I'm actually an introvert, but I like being goofy. I like being loud. I like having fun. So I'm looking for some company. So I just, you have to, but listen, this isn't about me. This is about you. I need, within your group, this is all, and by the way, you're getting points for everything you do tonight. All right, Mrs. Salisbury's in the back, and she's going to be scoring anything and everything she wants to. She has total discretion, okay? So take a minute and find out who is the one most outgoing individual of all the teenagers. I need one person. One person from each team. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get those people up here. All right. You do not need to take your shoes off for this. Now, the adult from that team, please join your teenager. I like having fun, and part of the fun is, I'm serious, with, you know, you teenagers, you're going to be running around all next week, you're going to be getting hot and sweaty, the adults are going to be yelling and laughing at you, why don't we laugh at them a little bit? So what I want to do tonight is, you haven't had a chance to come up with cheers yet, right? You don't have cheers yet? Okay, no, here, I have an old school cheer, of which the adults probably know. We have spirit. Yes, we do. We have spirit. How about you? Right? You know that one?
That's an old classic.
It's an old classic, right? Right. Hey, this is Odiorne time. All right? You know it? You know it? You know it? All right. So we're going to step back, and we're going to see you outdo each other. But please understand, she is scoring back there. You better put on a show. All right, you better put on a show for everybody, and that's the cheer. Everybody's got the same cheer, all right? So I'm going to go ahead and get out of the way, and I'll tell you when to go. You're going to do it all at the same time, all right up here. All six of us. It's because, listen to this, it's we have spirit, yes we do. So there has to be two people up here, all right, from each team. You, one team is going to win. One team. One team is going to win, all right? Take a minute to prepare. Stop. All right, oh, don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. All right, I want the teams to say, you know, are you the purple?
Yellow.
So, oh, I think I should have known that. All right, yellow team, who were your, were you happy with the presentation of your team? Okay. Purple? Purple? Okay, were you happy with theirs or with yellow's? Okay. All right. Green team, were you happy with yours? Or yellow's? Or yellow's? All right. All right. All right. I think you got, do you have any, who won that one? Oh, without a doubt. All right. Okay, you guys can go back to your teams. I was a bit surprised that there wasn't more of the pointing and you know, there was a lot of yelling going on, but I was kind of anticipating pointing at each other. Come here, Kirsten. All right. Kirsten is desperately trying to get points for her team tonight. All right? So, because they have how many?
Okay, we'll be fine. Zero's fine.
Zero's fine. Okay. I think it was more like, you know, we got to do this together. Ready? Ready? All right? We have to do it as a you have to do it as a straight face. You can't laugh. You can't laugh.
I have to do the cheer.
We have to do the cheer with me. Straight-faced, serious, like intensity. Yeah, yeah. All right. You want me to start, or you want to start? Oh yeah, oh yeah. All right. Hey, we don't need all the. Hey, listen up here. We got to see if Green Team gets some points here. All right. Are you gonna start, or am I gonna start? I'm gonna start. All right. All right, now listen, straight face, straight face. I should put this down.
We got spirit, yes we do. We got spirit, how about you?
We got spirit, yes we do. We got spirit, how about you?
And the Pharisees and scribes complained, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." So he spoke this parable to them, saying, "What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost.' I say to you that likewise there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 just persons who need no repentance. All right? That's all you get to see. That's the story. Now, take a minute or two, figure out what the acting. You got to remember the story, all right? And you're going to act it out. And we'll do it randomly, and then we'll see how you guys do. All right, Mrs. Salisbury, do you think we should give any points for the team that volunteers to go first? Do you think, should we? Sorry, okay. All right, teams, just let me have your attention. The first team to volunteer to go first gets some points. Anybody? All right. You guys ready to go then? If you volunteered, that means you're ready. All right, let's see. Luke 15, 1 through 7. All right, let us know when you're actually starting, okay? Oh, are you starting? Okay, here we go. Everybody pay attention.
Guys, look, I found the sheep. I'm so happy. Everybody, let's go celebrate. Yeah.
All right. What team wants to go next? Green wants to go. Green team. Anybody want the microphone? All right. Green team, you just have to let me know when you're starting and I'll hush everybody else. Are you done? Okay. that was a rough landing for that one sheep. All right, purple team, this is your chance. You've seen the standard. The standard has been set. Let's just see how you guys can do. You don't have as many people as the rest of them. So, all right, there we go. All right, Mr. Salisbury, you need to let me know when you're starting. And I would love for you to sound off a little bit, but that's, you know, so I mean, that means get a little louder. Are you starting? All right, here we go. Everybody quiet.
Why are you eating the sheep?
Oh, okay. All right. Hey, so listen, that was kind of a practice round. All right. I mean, I'm sure Mrs. Salisbury has some points going out on that one. But let's go to the next one. All right. Here we go. It's only one slide long. I think we need to go ahead and raise the creativity a little bit. And this isn't. It's not working for me back there, Caleb, or anybody. Hit the slide. Can you hit the slide? Just hit there. All right, there we go. Luke 15:8-10. Here we go. Oh, what woman having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it. And when she has found it, she calls her friends and neighbors together, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the piece which I lost." Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. All right, so got that one?
Yeah.
All right. All right, we have our first volunteer. Come on up, Purple Team. Purple Team is coming up. All right. I think I heard someone say this is so dumb. I'm so cut to the heart here. All right, here we go. Ready? We need the Purple Team to come up, and they're going to get started here. So I need everybody's attention. Go for it, Purple Team. I can see why you volunteered. All right. What team wants to go next? All right, green's going. Green's going. All right, here we go. They're getting in order. They're getting all set. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Set. Go. Hey, I think we need some interpretation here. What were those people doing that had their hands up? They were furniture. Okay, I got that. That's why I wanted to point it out. All right. All right, yellow team. Let's see what you got. Okay, all right. Oh.
If only we all celebrated that much when someone came to me.
All right. There you go. Oh, Savannah, the original one you dropped is still over there, I think. There it is. Yes, the one that you actually lost. All right. All right, great job. Great job. I'm sure Mrs. Salisbury is really just struggling to know which team is leading. Here we go. This is actually a long one. This is our last one. And so this is going to take a lot of intensity, but for time, I think we also need to have some speed, all right, involved here. Then he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood, and not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. Then he went and joined himself to the citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he had come, but when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough to, have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants." And he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight and am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet. And bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found, and they began to be merry. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came to draw near to the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, your brother has come, and because he has received him safe and sound, your father has killed the fatted calf. But he was angry and would not go in. Therefore his father came out and pleaded with him. So he answered and said to his father, lo, these many years I have been serving you. I never transgressed your commandment at any time, and yet you never gave me a young goat that I might make merry with my friends. But as soon as this son of yours, who has devoured your livelihood with harlots, you killed the fatted calf for him. And he said to him, son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. It was right that we should make merry and be glad, for your brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found. All right, that's the last one. Remember, true follower of Jesus has something, and we're going to talk about it. So put your thoughts together. We got to go quickly on this. All right. So come on down, purple team. All right, now just hang out for a second here. I'm working on something. All right, you guys ready? Okay. Now, you like to have fun and you like surprises, right? Here's a surprise. All right, here's a surprise. They're going to act to a certain point, and I'm going to tell them, stop. The next team has to come in at that point and pick up the story until I say stop, and then the third team has to bring it home. All right? Yeah. All right? Yeah. So we got purple team up here first. All right? Now that you guys know this, do you want to rethink whether you're ready to start off? All right, this is a long story, but okay, we're going to see how we do here. And I guess some of this has to have been on me, but when I say stop, you just stop. And then who's next? Who's next? Purple or yellow? I mean, I'm sorry, green or yellow?
Yellow.
Yellow, and then green's bringing it home. All right. So listen, we got to see how seamless that can be. When I say to them, stop, you've got to just jump right in. All right. All right. Ready, set, go, purple team. Stop. 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 Bring it home. All right. Hey, good job, everybody. Go ahead and grab a seat. Go ahead and grab your seat. All right. I still want to give you some time to just hang out for a little bit. And thanks for coming out tonight. All right. I hope you at least had a little fun with that. I know I did. All right. So what I want you to do is for the next, just turn on quietly, talk to your group. Just talk quietly, talk to your group, and tell me if you can fill in that last statement. The dashes there do not represent letters, okay? They're just dashes. It's just a line. The font made it look separated. So a true follower of Jesus has something. Based on those three parables, I would like you to answer or fill in the blank. All right, talk about it for just a little bit. You got to come up with a group answer. Group answer. Oh, I see. I separated you from your groups. I apologize. So, let's just go ahead and see if we can't figure this out from where you're at. All right. I tell you what, the group leader needs to give the answer. The adult of each group. Mr. Salisbury, do you have an answer? Don't tell it to me. Do you have one? Okay. Do you guys have one over here yet? Okay, you have one? You guys have one? Not yet? Okay. The other two already have it, so you're coming in third place here on having an answer. Okay, all right. Can we have the leaders up here, the adult leaders? Let me get you up here. Go ahead, Mr. Salisbury, get up here. All right. I want you to all face the camera. Okay. All right. Now I want you to stay. Yeah. Come, okay. Ready? On three. All four of us are going to say the answer. I'm going to say the right one. Okay. All right. Yeah. That's a good point. So on three, you're going to say the answer, and on four, I'm going to say the answer. How's that? All right. One, two, three.
Joy.
Yeah. What did you say?
Value.
Joy. Joy. Okay. All right. Green team, I got to tell you, I'm trying to help. Okay. All right. I have no idea where the points fall. Go ahead. Now grab your seats. I'm sorry. That was the answer. Joy was the answer. All right. And so really, as you looked at these three parables, as someone might want a picture of that. All right. That's quite the picture back there. All right. Real quick. I'm going to make this really quick. All right. So each of the stories had joy in it. Two of them actually had the word. The third one did not have the word, but it had the idea. And specifically, a true follower of Jesus has joy when a sinner repents. All right, that's really what they're getting across there. And why did I pick on this particular topic or try to have some fun this way? Well, you know, so often we come to you, whether I'm preaching on Sunday or someone else is teaching, and in any scenario, we come before you each week here. And oftentimes we're telling you what to do, how to be, how to act. And we don't necessarily talk about the joy of being in Christ, right? And so I can say to a true follower of Jesus has joy when a sinner repents. That is an aspect of joy, but that's not the exhaustive nature of joy. When I was your age, as part of my testimony, I was not characterized by having any joy because I was lost. And I tell people I had no interest in anything, right? I had no passion. I had no desire to do anything, to be anything. I was just getting through life. And then Jesus saved me. And then I understood that all the things I tried to do, you know, going out to the bars, hanging out with different people when I was in college and all that stuff, all the things that I did was really just trying to fit into a group of people that didn't honor God. And I found out what true joy is. And true joy is honestly being who God created you to be. And what I've already bragged on you folks, by the way, today. I won't tell you the whole discussion, but I talked to a youth pastor who called us from the Midwest. And he was inquiring about our youth group and had some questions. I was answering his questions. And I said, one of the things that stands out to me about this youth group is that there doesn't appear, now there probably is at some level, but there's no cliquishness here. It seems like you all just receive and accept one another for who you are. I love that. I love the fact that you guys can just be a one large group and have fun. All right? So I want to encourage you to keep that up. But the joy that is unspeakable is knowing that you have purpose in life, that you are who you are, and it's okay. Not only is it okay, but it's a reason to praise God. And I want to just encourage you to just pursue the joy that God has for your life. And that where if you want to be a joy stealer, it's going to be doing those things that would not honor God. But find your joy in Christ, right? Search for it and then live it out and have fun with it and enjoy being a Christian, all right? That's really all I wanted to say. Being a Christian is like nothing else I've ever experienced in my life. And if you're looking anywhere else, you're going to find emptiness. But joy is new every morning in Christ. And I just wanted to share that with you. I'm going to close this in prayer. It's 7:59. Hang out for a bit. Have some more fun. Thank you for all your participation today. And if I embarrassed anyone, that was my goal. No. Okay. So let's pray. Father, I thank you for tonight. And thank you for the enthusiasm of these teenagers and their leaders. Lord, I just pray that as we head into Teen Week, next week, Lord, that you would just be glorified in the attitudes that they bring to all the events. Lord, I pray that those teenagers who come from outside of this circle would be welcomed in as friends and in a way that would encourage them that we are different in Christ. We're different than the world. In Christ, we have joy. We have it unspeakable, and we're willing to receive others as Christ would receive them. Lord, I pray that we'd have a great time next week, but Lord, I pray that you do a spiritual work in every life. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks, folks. Hey! Woo!
But here's what I'll do. I'm gonna wait on you. I'm gonna wait on you. I've tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. Tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna.